everybody, sorry for my kind of disheveled look. I just got back from school and from the post office, so I walked back from the post office to my house, carrying this huge box. It was wrapped, of course, in like a cardboard box, but I took that off because you don't want to see that. You're not here to watch me open a cardboard box. You're here to watch me open this box. So I have Haldrin here, who the body is for. I'll put him up the shelf and we'll get back to him once I have it open. But here is the box. And my cat is here as well, and he's already causing problems. He's probably going to walk in front of the camera, but here we go. So I got the... It's kind of cute. I got the The senior body, I believe it's SD17, I think. Here it is. Look at those cute bows though. It's adorable. But I got slapped real hard by customs. It's kind of upsetting me. So I might actually have to sell the head that I got with it. Because I kind of could use the money. What are you doing? Don't play with my new box. Okay, so we're gonna open the fluff. Oh my god, oh god, wow. The resin smell. Oh my god, it just like slapped me when I opened it. Okay, so here's the head cap. I think those are the hands, I guess. Oh, you can't be sitting in front of the camera, dear. You can't just like be in the way like that. Okay, let me just... Sorry for the screechy noses. I know it's kind of... Here are the hands. I'll open them in a second. But I'm kind of... Oh, here it is. I'm going to open the head first. Do I have... Yes, I do have my scissors with me. So... I got slapped by customs, and I think for now, until maybe my funds have grown, well, I'm not really planning on buying anything right now, because I'm like, being a student is kind of expensive. I mean, I do know, it's a nice head. Let me just open his wig cap as well before I show you him. I mean, I have to pay sometimes for... I don't have to pay much. I know the American system is quite different from ours. We don't have to pay our... we didn't have to pay our... studies. Our parents do so. Because I know that's kind of a different story in America, I think. The magnet just snapped off. Interesting. Am I being weird or does this not fit? Hang on, let me take off this magnet for a second. Am I like not getting this or does this head cap just like not fit? Oh, there we go, it snaps. Interesting. That sits on quite well. I feel like it doesn't quite fit. Sit flush, but this is the head, which I'm probably going to sell since I could kind of use the money, honestly. I'm not sure. I don't know. It looks very female to me. It's a male head, actually, but looks very female to me, if I'm honest. So that's the head. I'm just gonna put that aside. Okay, making sure my dear little cat doesn't eat it up. Okay, oh, right, a little magnet. Right, so here's the certificate, I believe. Yes, the certificate of authenticity. And this is the mummy. Let me check that I'm not missing anything. But I'm quite sure this should be everything. Where am I going to put this box? I'm just going to put that over there. Okay, I'm going to take a quick sip of my coffee. Because I had to wake up at 6, so I'm kind of feeling it now. So conclusion is, after being like drastically hit with that customs fee that I have never had before, actually. He's big, but he's not as big as like my Hulk is, so that's interesting. Like, the EID body that I do have for sale, actually, for I think a fair. Oh god, this is gonna bother me. He is so loose though. He's kind of he's floppy. Like, this will be interesting. Okay. No, those arms. Oh right, he does have that locking mechanism. That's right. Let me see if I can stand him in this like loose situation. Okay, so he's probably gonna be not gonna be a good stander. Though this is not too bad. Like, that's okay, that's okay. Like, how to do these joints work? Okay, so they need a little bit more effort to get out. I do like the way he's sculpted. Not sure if I like these mobility joints. I think they're rather weird. I mean, like, they are not sculpted to be twisted. I think they're sculpted to create this kind of mobility, I think. Okay. He'll need some tightening for sure. Okay, let me take off this. His hook has totally sunk into his body. Oh my god! Like, what? How is this even possible? Like, what the actual fuck? I mean, I'm sorry for the language, but honestly, like, this should never happen to a BJD. Sorry. I mean, honestly. I'm a little bit like puzzled. No, oh, no, don't go sit in there. Okay, I have a little hole now. Okay, get the string on there. Like, I am not happy with this. Like, what the actual. Like, this hook is way too small to be sitting in that head like that. I'm gonna have to put that head on, like, now, because otherwise that neck is gonna get damaged. Like it's no one's business. So like the resin match is kind of horrible. This body, this head is kind of greenish, kind of. Oh my god, that fits perfectly, I think. Let me just get the hook. Oh my god, he finally has a body. Oh my god. Is that in the right way? I don't think so. No, definitely the other way. Okay. He doesn't have any hands. Poor him. Well, the neck fits perfectly, actually. So this is him right now. I'm not sure. I think with some clothes I'll like the proportions, but I feel like his neck's a little bit short, but I think that will work out just fine. What is happening to your knees? What's to deal with that? Oh god. That did not sound healthy. That does not sound healthy. Oh my god. Like, what's the deal with this? Okay. this is how you sit up, I guess. Okay, so you can do this pose, which is interesting, though I doubt he'll be able to keep up himself. Okay, there you go. He sits. I'm just going to pop on his wig cap and his wig again. So give me a second. I'll be showing him once more. Because I know I tend to look at my dolls myself and then not really. Oh god, he's going to jump down again. Don't. Stay up. Stay there. You're good there. But I know I tend to, like, have my dolls off camera. Let me just have you sitting right here. I think you'll do better. I hope. Okay. I have never, ever had a doll with the thigh joint, and I'm not sure how I'm feeling about it. I know a lot of people don't like it, and a lot of people just try to get rid of it as soon as they see their doll has one, by just, like, hot gluing it stuck so it won't move anymore. Is that? No, that's not far enough. Oh, there he is again. I'll get him off in a second. Don't sit down. You're not going to be staying. Come here. He's so big though. Like, my cat, he's not a kitten anymore. He's huge. He weighs 5 kilo right now. Okay. I feel like you're interesting. Like, I don't know. Seems like he can sit alright. But I'm not. I don't know what the deal is with the knees. I feel like, oh god. That clacking noise is not a noise that I like to hear. Like, I'm afraid to actually just let his knees be fully bent. I don't know how that's actually like. Okay, there we go. It's really interesting. Okay, I'll have him facing you if I can get his body to stay. Oh, okay, that'll work for now. Then I'm gonna unwrap his hands. Legs are really weird. No, you're not about to fall back. I'm not allowing you to do that. No. Not sure how I feel about the wig sitting on his head right now. I don't know, I felt like it was better earlier, but I don't know, kind of sits weird. I don't know, it used to be Luna's wig actually. I don't really have a good wig for him because he has this really weird head size. He has a flat head on top. I don't know if you've ever seen that before, but that means that he kind of doesn't really fit the normal standard, like, wig making, because the wigs are made to fit. Oh, his hands are really pretty though. I really like the sculpting on his hands. Don't know if my camera is going to pick it up though. You can see it a little bit, the veins, like right there. Like there, you can see that he has beautiful veins on his hand, which I know some people don't like, but I do like it. I don't know, I have something with it, I guess. Let me just put that on. So I'm not sure how this system actually works, but right now I won't be able to get anything on there as that hook. Okay, there you go. I think it's that you have to twist it down. Okay, I guess it's like that. Does this, like, lock into any position, or how does this work? Like that, I guess? Okay, like that. Okay, you sit. Oh, we have a the grey friend joining us again. I'm sorry that he's walking in front of the camera all the time. He's just too nosy, and the fact that something new has arrived, it's kind of a... It's kind of sparking his interest, I guess. Clear this. Okay, put his other hand on, and then, oh dear, why do you have lashes on your in your hair, my dear? Okay. Not sure how the ball is supposed to lock onto the hand, because I think it's supposed to do that. I think it's supposed to go like this, but it's not quite gliding in there. I feel like it's too big. Maybe it's the other way around. Like, oh man. Like, why is it not? Oh, there we go. There we go. Fiddling always works. Okay, let me just get him up to full height. I really, really like his hands. That was like one of the things that I just really didn't like about the EID body. I feel like his hips won't be particularly strong, which is kind of like a burden to get. I think the aesthetic does fit him. Let me just play around with this for a second. Yes, I think this will work out. Now the problem is, will I be able to deal with the floppiness of this body? Because I really like the aesthetic. That's not the problem. It's the posing that kind of worries me. I do think his head is kind of big for this body, but... Come on, Thor, come on. Okay, well, okay. It's only an ear. We can kind of live with that. Oh, sorry for the doll nudity, by the way. I don't really give out, like... Don't be offended. I mean, it's a box opening. What do you expect? That my doll is fully clothed? Like, that never happens. Honestly. But, I'm sorry. I did not warn you for that. Maybe you wanted warnings. I know in America they warn for everything, but... We don't really do that here, I guess. We're like, you were supposed to know that. I mean, like, it's kind of your own fault that you didn't know. Anyway, I'm not talking about prejudice or something, or, like, stereotypes. Anyway. I should kind of get his hair fixed. But I do think I'm gonna, like, work around this wig for a little while, because I'm not really sure what I want his hair to look like just yet, now that he has his own buddy. And I'm really excited to make him clothes as well. I think I want to make like long kind of cloak type outfits. Though I would rather want to stay away of like the stereotypes of elves, which he is, of course. He does have the elf ears. There you go. So I would want to try to stay away from that, but let me just see if I can get him to stand. Well, there we go. There he is, standing. Let's see how well. Okay, so he's not very stable. Oh god, you're dramatic. Like, he's so floppy. Like, what's the deal? Not really used to that. But yeah, so the conclusion is, of today's lesson, that I won't be buying from outside of the EU for now. I'm gonna stick to some indoor companies. For instance, like Merry Doll Round is situated in Spain, which is absolutely perfect for me. That definitely doesn't have like high pay customs and taxes. So yeah, that's him. Maybe you can... No, I don't think you'll be able to pull off a kneel stand. I know my Merry Doll Round does it, and it's absolutely amazing. I would love to see Merida Round make a boy. That would be so amazing. Nope, he's not gonna be able to stand like that, so I'm gonna have to hold him. Okay, but here is the head, which I'm gonna be putting up for sale. It won't be like too high of a price, because I kind of want him just. I don't know. My original intention was to make him into Luna, but I don't know. I don't really particularly like his nose. I don't know why. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just like I don't like it for the character, I guess. I'm just really happy with the head she has now. Oh my god, I cut myself. When did that happen? Like, I have this little cut underneath my nail. Anyway, so this is the head. If you do have any interests, shoot me an email. Like, honestly, cat, go do your business somewhere else. And I have this dramatic person lying in my hands. This will be quite annoying for a little while, because I won't be able to restring him anytime soon. So yeah, that's Heldrin. And this head, so if you have any interest in this head, just shoot me an email. Just shoot me an email with like a price suggestion and I'll let you know what I think. That's that. I'll put my email down below. And if you're interested in my EID body, I'm also willing to actually let it go for quite a cheap price. So just shoot me like an offer. And we'll talk about it. We'll see what we can come up with. I'm pretty reasonable, I should think. I just really, that body, I just really want it gone, honestly. Like, I have it packed up already. Like, I don't have it in its box just yet because maybe someone would like it to be shipped unstrung without the box, which I can understand because the box is huge. And he's not really that hard to string, honestly. He'll come with a manual, if I'm correct, if it's still in the box. And I just want him gone. He'll be kind of like a project body, I guess. You can do anything you like with it. He's perfect for modding. And I will be reasonable coming for like a really low price. So just shoot me an email if you have any interest in him or my little head that I have. He's brand new. He just came from the company. You saw me unboxing him. I'll keep him safe if anyone is interested. So shoot me an email. And we'll just figure it out. Like, you can just ask me, like, I would want to pay this, not more, well, less, I guess, always, but and then we'll just talk and see what we can agree on. But I kind of want to let things go. I don't want to have too much dolls sticking around. I already have Luna's old head staying around, which I'm kind of like iffy about. I don't know what I'm doing with that. So yeah, that's this guy. I feel like these knees could use like some modding or something, but I know how I am with mods. I tend to really want to do them, just never end up doing them. Let me see just quickly how his double joints look though. Okay, so they're kind of similar to what I had on my Angel Studio body. Okay, interesting. Anyway, so that's Haldrin for ya. You can hear his legs flopping around. That'll be kind of a worry, but we'll worry about that later. So, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you very soon. Thanks for watching. Bye!